हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन वर्किंग ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन क्लास 9th. यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड पॉलिटिकल एग्जीक्यूटिव्स. टू हुम हु आर द पॉलिटिकल एग्जीक्यूटिव? दैट इज अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री executive that is elected by the people. In democratic country, executive, to whom they are called the executive that is elected by the people, means hum executive ko as a our representative we elect, means in democratic country executive that is elected by the people for specific period. They are not permanent. They are specific period, for example 5 years or 6 years, is called the political executive. Example, political leaders. Example, that is political leaders. Generally, they contest election. We cast our vote to them. So, political leaders. Executives are basically political leaders. People who are appointed on a long term basis, it is called the permanent executive or civil servant. So there is difference between the permanent executive and political executive. Political executive means our representative to whom we elect by casting our vote for handling policy, making the laws for us, all this. So they are political executive, they are political leaders. Who are the political executive? Basically they are political leaders, and who makes the policy and execute the policy. Then person who are appointed on the long term basis, they are called the permanent executive. Permanent executive, they are selected through the process of examination, and they appoint for long term on the basis, that is called the permanent executive or civil servant. MPSC, UPSC, whatever services are there, IAS, administrative services, all that, or government servant or civil servant, they are permanent executive. So this is I thought that you understood that one, that difference between political executive and permanent executive. So permanent executive, they are civil servant, and political executive, they are political leaders. So they remain in the office even when the ruling party changes. Permanent executive, they remain in the same office or another office, even though even when the party, ruling party changes. Ruling party change be with the permanent executive, they are permanent and they remain in the office for execute the policies. Then these officers work under the political executive, but these officers, that is permanent executive, they work under the control of political executive. Political executive means leaders, political leaders, cabinets, and assist them in carrying out the day-to-day administration. Then ministers are more powerful than the civil servant. Ministers are more powerful in ministers are more powerful than the civil servant, even though they are usually more educated. Civil servant, they are more educated and have more expert knowledge of the subject comparing to the political executive, ministers, cabinet. The reason is that democracy, the will of the people is supreme. In democracy, this is the truth, that will of the people is supreme. Minister is elected by the people. Minister is elected by whom? By the people, and thus empower to exercise the will of the people on their behalf. Means minister is elected by whom? By the people, those who we call the political executive. They are elected by the people. In democracy, the will of people is supreme. Then empower to exercise the will of the people on their behalf. Means we send our representative to work on the behalf of us for making the policies, executing policies, or preparing, planning, all these things. He is finally answerable to the people. Our representative, they are answerable for the people. We can ask the question for their respective or regarding their department. What is going? Means pure transparency would be there. So, he is finally answerable to the people. Who? That is political executives. All the consequences of his decision. That is why the minister takes all the final decisions. So, here cabinet or minister, permanent executive or personal, that is also called the personal assistant. So, they have more knowledge even though education, but they assist to whom? Political executive. Minister takes all the decision. Only this permanent executive or civil servant suggests them. So, this is about, come to the, that thing again we will discuss through the books. Political and permanent executive. What is difference between this? That we have just seen. So, in a democratic country, two categories make up the executive. One that is elected by the people. They are also called the executive. Those who are elected by the people. But they are called the political executive, which are not permanent. And then political leaders who take the big decision fall in this category. In the second category, people are appointed on the long term. In second category of executive, these people, they are appointed on the long term basis. This is called the permanent executive or civil servant. Generally, this question asked in the exam. Difference between political executive and permanent executive with their examples. So, person working in civil services, those person works in the civil services, they are called the civil servant. They remain in the office even when the ruling party changes. Ruling party changes, so this doesn't affect of this permanent executive. They remain in the office. This officer work under the political executive. This executive, civil servant, they works under the control of whom? That is political executive, and assist them in the carrying out the day-to-day administration. Who assists this political executive? Permanent executive or civil servant. They assist to the, to whom? Political executives or ministers, cabinet ministers, for carrying out the day-to-day administration. Then come to here. So here, can you recall the role of political and non-political executive in the case of office memorandum? So, political executives, they makes the policy, programs, rules, and this after becoming the law or order, it is implemented by whom? By these permanent executives or civil servants. You might ask, why does the political executive have more powerful than the non-political executive? Question again, I am repeating, try to understand. Why does the political executive have more power? Obviously, political executive, they have more power comparing to the permanent executive than the non-political executive or permanent executive. Why is minister more powerful than the civil servant? Civil servants, they assist to the ministers, but ministers, they are more powerful. The civil servant is usually more educated and has more expert knowledge of that subject. Generally, permanent executives gives the post, a particular post on particular subject, because they are expert in that particular subject. So they appoint for assisting to the cabinet or ministers. Advisor working. The advisors working in the finance ministry know more about the economic than the finance minister. It is obviously minister, they are not expert in that particular subject, though the separate charge is given to them as a minister, but who assist him as expert, that is permanent executive, or they assist them because they have more knowledge about that particular subject and even education on that field. But still, ministers, they are more powerful. Sometimes ministers may know very little about the technical matter because basically they are not the technical experts, and that come under their ministry. So in this work, this executive, permanent executive, help this cabinet or ministers for handling the policies of particular ministry. This could easily happen in the ministries like defense, industry, health, science, and the technology, mining, etc. Means all the charge gives to the cabinet ministers in center and as well as in the state, but they are not technically expert in that field. But permanent executive, they are technically expert in that field, and they makes the plan for announcing the policies, or all that contribution goes to the political executive. But actual work, it is done by whom? That is permanent executive. So why should the ministers have the final say on this matter? The reason is very simple. Means here, who are more powerful? Ministers, ministry, cabinet. So reason is very simple. In democracy, the will of people is supreme. It is fact in the, or it expect in the democracy, that will of the people, it should be supreme. It is supreme. And laws would be to fulfill the needs of these people. It gives the priority. The minister is elected by the people and thus empowered to exercise the will of people on their behalf. Means they have to attend or responsive to the people. She is finally answerable to the people for all the consequences of her decision. means who is finally answerable to the people? That ministers. Because policies or programs introduced by the government, they are by the name of who makes the that is name of the cabinet or ministers. That is why the minister takes all the final decision. Minister takes all the final decision, and this permanent executive help or assist to them for taking the final decision. The minister decides the overall framework and objectives in which decision on policy should be made. Minister is not expected to be as expert in the matter of her ministry. It is not compulsory, or it is not expected that particular minister is there. For example, law minister, if there is law minister, so it is not required they have to take the law education, but their assistant, it is important is that their permanent assistant, those who assist for formulating the policies, so they have to be proper education in that ministry. The ministers takes the advice of expert on all the technical matters. So here, though the policy formulated by the cabinet, but they technically, whatever problems are there, that who guide the ministers, that executives, permanent executive, because they are knowledgeable or they are expert in that particular ministry. But very often, expert hold different opinions or place before her more than one option. Depending on what the overall objective is, the ministers decide. So, depending on what the overall objective, whatever overall objectives are there, the minister decide. Minister takes the decision, and for taking the decision, making the policies, who technically assist personal assistance or PA or political, permanent executive, they help in their work for taking the decision of particular ministry. Then, actually, this happened in any large organization. Those who understand the overall picture take most important decision and not the experts. Then, page number 87 of your textbook. So, the experts can tell the root. Expert, those who are knowledgeable or taking education on particular that ministry. So, the experts can tell the root. But someone with the larger view decides the destination. In democracy, elected minister perform this role. So, in democracy, our elected representative or elected minister, they perform this role for taking particular decision, but only assist them, civil servant. Here, ministers are powerful, that we have discussed. Means, though they are usually more educated or have more expert knowledge of this subject, we are talking about the civil servant. The reason is that democracy, the will of people is supreme. Logo ki will jo hai, wo democracy mein supreme hai. मिनिस्टर इज इलेक्टेड बाय द पीपल एंड दस इम्पावर टू एक्सरसाइज द विल ऑफ पीपल ऑन देयर बिहाफ. सो ही इज फाइनली आंसरेबल. मिनिस्टर्स दे आर फाइनली आंसरेबल टू द पीपल बिकॉज वी हैव इलेक्टेड देम फॉर ऑल द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज ऑफ हिज डिसीजन. मीन्स प्योर ट्रांसपेरेंसी वुड बी देयर फॉर द वर्किंग ऑफ मिनिस्टर एंड दैट इज वाई द मिनिस्टर टेक्स ऑल द फाइनल डिसीजन. मिनिस्टर टेक्स ऑल द फाइनल डिसीजन. सो कम टू द पेज नंबर 87. Prime Minister and Council of Minister. Prime Minister and Council of Minister. Here, Prime Minister is the most important political institution in the country. So, Prime Minister and his Council is also, Council and Cabinet is also called the one of the institute in the country, which is most important. Yet there is no direct election to the post of Prime Minister. Is there direct election for the post of Prime Minister? No. First of all, they have to elect from the particular party or independent. And then after getting the majority for particular party, then leader of that majority party in Lok Sabha becomes the Prime Minister as per our constitutional provision. The President appoint the Prime Minister. President who appoint the Prime Minister? President. But the President cannot appoint anyone she likes. Lekin Prime Minister, after appointment of the Prime Minister, from whom? By the President. So after Miss Prime Minister, they select, Prime Minister select the members for the making policies. So Prime Minister is appointed by the President. Thing is clear. But President cannot be appoint anyone she likes. प्रेसिडेंट अदर मिनिस्टर्स या काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर इलेक्ट नहीं कर सकते. बट प्राइम मिनिस्टर सजेस्ट द लिस्ट. प्राइम मिनिस्टर सिलेक्ट द लिस्ट ऑफ द नेम ऑफ द मिनिस्टर्स टू हुम हैव टू गिव द सेपरेट चार्ज ऑफ पर्टिकुलर डिपार्टमेंट और पोर्टफोलियो. सो इट इज रेस्ट ऑन ओनली Prime Minister. Then Prime Minister produce the list which he has selected the members as a cabinet for giving the separate charge for particular ministry. So he produced the list to President, and President consensus is important. It is not depend upon the President. But totally, which minister have to take as a particular ministry charge for giving the charge of particular ministry, it depends upon the Prime Minister. Only Prime Minister produce list to the President, and President has to be accept. The President appoint the leaders. President appoints the leaders of the majority party or coalition of the party. What is coalition? That we have studied. So coalition of the party that commands the majority in Lok Sabha as a Prime Minister. So who select the Prime Minister? Only President appoint the Prime Minister. But for the Prime Minister, he would be the leader of the majority party in Lok Sabha or coalition governments, coalition parties. In case no single party or alliance gets the majority, no single party or alliance means what? Combination of more than one party, that is alliance for forming the majority or forming the government. So the President appoints the person most likely to secure the majority support. So though the president select prime minister, but it is not depend upon his will. But what thing is important, that he should be the leaders of majority party in Lok Sabha or coalition parties, combination of different parties. Majority is important. Leader of the majority party can become the president. President appoint prime minister, but to whom have to select, it is not in the hand of president, but it depends upon the majority. The prime minister does not have fixed tenure. Prime minister ka fixed tenure nahi hota. Tenure means span. There is no fixed span or tenure of the prime minister. He continues in the power. We are talking about the prime minister. Prime minister continues in his power so long as he remain the leader of majority party or coalition. Jab tak wo majority party ka leader hai ya coalition parties ka leader hai, tab tak wo president prime minister reh sakta. Then here after the appointment of the prime minister, I hope you have understood what is the process of selecting prime minister, what are the conditions essential, that is majority, who appoint them, but that is nominal. Actual, he should be the leader of majority party, and appointment it is done by the name of president. So after the appointment of prime minister, the president appoints the other ministers. President kya appoint karte hai, other ministers, on the advice of prime minister. Here advice of the prime minister is important. Prime minister produce the list for the ministers for particular department, and president has to accept them while appointing. So ministers are usually from the party or coalition that has the majority in Lok Sabha. So ministers also should be from the majority parties, those who form the government. The prime minister is free to choose the ministers. Ministers means here a right given to the prime minister, that choosing the ministers, making the list and produce to the president, as long as they are the member of parliament. Sometime a person who is not a member of parliament can also become a minister. Kabhi kabhi hota hai aisa ki person is not the member of parliament. Sometime person who is not the member of parliament can also become the minister. Wo minister ho sakte. But such a, even though it is true for the regional or state government, as you know about Maharashtra, in Maharashtra government, that is Shiv Sena, and leader is Uddhav Thackeray, but he was not the member of Vidhan Sabha, though he elected as a minister or chief minister. But such a person has to get elected to one of the house of the parliament within the 6 months of appointment as a minister. If any person is appointed as a minister or even though chief minister, just I have given the example of the Uddhav Thackeray ji. So, but after getting a designation of minister within the 6 months, he should be elected from the House of Parliament. Elected one of the House of the Parliament, Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha, within the 6 months of the appointment. Appointment होने के बाद, within the 6 months. So this is about the how ministers are appointed. Then another one, council of the minister. Another one is what? Council of minister. Cabinet ministers. Cabinet ministers are usually top level ministers. Cabinet ministers, they are usually top level ministers of the ruling party. Cabinet ministers, they are from only the ruling party, those who form the government, or parties who are in the charge of the major ministries. Usually, the cabinet ministers meet to take the decision. Usually, cabinet ministers, those who have lot of experience, particular field, and senior most leaders or knowledge of particular ministry, they appoint prime minister, select their names. Minister meet to take the decision in the name of the council of ministers. Cabinet is thus the inner ring. Cabinet is called the inner ring of the council of ministers. Means they should be of the majority party. That cabinet ministers also and other ministers or council of ministers, they are also from the majority party. It comprises about 20 ministers. So cabinet minister, their quantity, it is near about the 20. They should be senior most leader, they have a lot of experience for particular ministry. It comprises about 20 ministers. Their quantity, it is of the 20, whose, that is cabinet minister, they should belonging to the ruling party. Then next one, ministers of the state with the independent charge. Minister of state with the independent charge, those who have independent charge of the particular ministry, or that is called the minister of state. First rank, that was the cabinet minister, those who are the head of particular ministry. Then minister of state or state minister, they have also independent, they also gets the independent charge, are usually in charge of the smaller ministries. They participate in the cabinet meetings only when they specially invited. In cabinet meeting, even though state ministers, they do not get the permission for attending the meeting unless it is invited by the cabinet ministers. If they invite for the meeting, enter in the meeting of the cabinet minister. Otherwise, there is no vice to this state minister, though they have separate charge of particular ministry. But inviting them by the cabinets, it is important. They participate in the cabinet meeting only when specially invited. जब तक वो invite नहीं करते हैं ministers, cabinet minister, तब तक ये state minister, they can't attend the meetings of the cabinet ministry. And third point is that ministers of state are attached to minister of state, they are attached to and required to assist cabinet ministers. Means this cabinet state minister, they assist to the cabinet minister. If they call, they enter in that meetings. Since it is not practical for all the ministers to meet regularly and discuss everything, the decisions are taken in the cabinet meetings only. That is why parliamentary democracy in most countries is often known as cabinet form of the government. What cabinet form of the government? The cabinet work as a team. Cabinet members, they work as a team. The minister may have different views and opinions. It is obviously that ministers, they also have or may have different views and different opinions. But everyone has to own up to every decision of the cabinet. Means they takes the decision. Who take the decision? Cabinet ministers for particular ministry. Then so here no ministers can openly criticize any decision. No ministers can openly criticize any decisions of the government. Government ke decision par koi bhi ministers, they do not have the voice to criticize the government, even if it is about the another ministry or department. Means koi bhi kisi bhi ministry kisi bhi department pe criticize ya talking against, it is not power given to the to whom? To any ministers. Every minister has secretaries, personal secretaries, or just we have seen that is permanent executive. Secretaries means for giving, for assisting to the ministers who are civil servant. Aur unhi ko kya kaha hai? Civil servant. The secretaries provide the necessary background information to the ministers. What is the work of secretaries? They provide the necessary background information to the ministers to take the decision. Means they helps for taking the decision. Actual decision made by whom? Ministers. Cabinet minister. But secretaries help them for coming particular decision. The cabinet as team, the cabinet as a team is assisted by the cabinet secretary. This include may senior civil servant. Secretaries kon hote hai? Senior most civil servant who try to coordinate the working of different ministers. Means they help or they contribute for the coordinate the working of different ministers. So here we are going to, or this is the end of this part. Next part will start